Hey guys, okay, so I have a video for you guys of what's in my diaper bag. Oh, it's scratched. Diaper bag video. And this is gonna be Addison's hospital bag. I know that it's overpacked. I don't care. I like to be prepared. So this first little pocket here is just a changing pad. So we'll probably keep that in there. Sorry, you hear Callie making noise in the background. Keep that in there. And I'll be adjusting this as, obviously, she arrives and I decide what we need in her bag. I am a Montessori teacher and we are opening up an infant toddler room. So I will actually move to infants and I'll get to have Addison with me in my class. So I'm not sure that I'll be taking a bag with me all the time because most of her stuff will already be there and it can just be left there. So one of the side pockets here, just a burp cloth that my mama had made, just little teddy bears. I'm filming in my kitchen, by the way, trying to see if that's better lighting. I'm not sure. You guys will have to let me know if you guys prefer this lighting or the lighting in my living room. So just a little burp rag there, and then this pocket on the side here doesn't have anything. It will be where a bottle will go, but I plan to exclusively breastfeed, and then I'll be able to breastfeed her at work too. I would like to transition her to bottles eventually because if I'm busy with another child, I need her to be able to take a bottle. So we'll be doing that eventually. This is Just One You by Carter's diaper bag. And then it has the stroller straps on both sides. And the inside compartment, let's see if I can get, is pretty big. Okay, so Addison will be arriving sometime late September or early October. They don't think that I'll make it to October. I'll say more about that in my update that I'm going to do in just a minute because I've been totally lagging on those. Sorry. But anyways, they don't think I'll make it to October. So I have like three sets of clothes in here because I don't know how big she'll be. I am being induced 2 weeks early minimum. So with that, I mean, I'm assuming she's going to be relatively small because she won't be full term, but we'll see. And this is actually a sheet, a bag that one of her sheets came in. This is from Target, by the way. And I just thought it was a good idea to go ahead and use it and store some of her goodies in. So here's a Baby Gannix diaper cream and then some samples. I have like the Boogie Wipe samples, a couple of those. I also have a travel size Johnson & Johnson, which I don't know. I got it as a gift, so I'll use it. And then I also got this Mustela. Is that how you say it? This is another wash. But I thought it would be good just to keep them in there in case we're up at my grandpa's or something like that. Let's see. And then I'll show you guys the bag empty so you can see where all the pockets are. I'm just pulling everything out right now. This is just a Ziploc bag full of passies. And I will let her use a pacifier after a few weeks, just, or maybe sooner, depends on how her latch is and make sure we don't have any latch issues or tongue ties or lip ties or anything like that. But this is her Wubba Nubba. She has two of these. This is the elephant one. Pretty cute. And I washed all of these nipples and got them all clean. And then there's a passy pack. And then I have, I know this is totally overkill, but who knows what she's going to like. So I went ahead and just packed a bunch of them. This is the ma'am, let me know. Passy. And then here's one on a passy clip. And I think this one's the ma'am too. And it says, I love mommy. And the pacifier clip says, I love mommy too. And then gotta have her Giants, San Francisco Giants. Flip it the right way here. There we go. Giants passy. So three different brand, or two different sizes and three different brands. So I've got all of those, and then I'm just keeping them in a Ziploc bag so that they all stay nice and clean. And then this is the side compartment that I'm pulling out. This is just a medical, like, safety kit or first aid kit, whatever you want to call it. With a comb, a brush, a nose aspirator, toothbrush, alcohol wipes. And then there's a little card in here. I'll fill that whenever she's born. So just keep that in there. I have one here at the house as well, so. Okay, and then this is just a little sample, couple of Pampers Swaddler diapers, and then some Pampers Sensitive Wipes. This is like a little clutch that I could grab if we're just gonna run in somewhere. It also comes with this clear little envelope, which I thought was kind of cool to put anything medical related or something that I might need for her in there. So that's the side compartment again. And now, let's see. I have one little lovey. This is just one that I liked, and so I pulled that out. One little lovey. And now we'll get into clothes. I know it's overkill. I know. I'm well aware. All right. So I have two preemie gowns. This is one of them. They all have the mittens on them. So this is if she's super tiny. And I don't have any other preemie clothes. I only have gowns. So we'll have to send someone out to grab something if she comes early. So another preemie gown with the mittens. And then these are newborns. So one of these might be her going home outfit. This one says Daddy's Girl. And it's got little ruffles on the butt. And she is going to be being born, like I said, late September, early October. And in Arkansas, it is starting to get a little chilly then. So I wanted to make sure that I had some warm clothes for her. This is also a newborn with the mittens and the footies. And this is just a pink and yellow. And then I did also bring a couple of 0 to 3. So little pink giraffe with footies. And then this one, and it says, I know my finger's small, but I have Daddy wrapped around it. And then I also brought this one, and I'm hoping that if she's big enough, or maybe even if she's too small, we'll just tuck it around her. But this, I'd like to take a photo of her for our newborn photography. Have her wearing this, and it says, you are the one we have prayed for. And then I just have a pair of pink pants. So those are all the big girl clothes, and then you saw all the teeny teenies. And then I also have a muslin swaddle, Aiden and I swaddle blanket. And I have another swaddle blanket. And then I just have like a regular blanket, little receiving blanket. And I have those in the bottom of the bag. And then I have about 10 diapers, Pampers Swaddlers diapers with the yellow that turns to blue. I am going to be using cloth diapers, but for the beginning, especially as my husband is learning how to use and change diapers, I'm going to go ahead and make it easy for him and just use the disposables. And when he feels more comfortable, then we'll go ahead and transition to our cloth diapers. I also have a pack of water wipes that I wanted to bring. And then in the little mesh compartments in here, I have 3 pairs of socks. And then in the other side, I have, 2 mittens and a little pink hair bow. So I thought good just to have that with us. And then in the, there's a zipper compartment. I have some pure lanolin, and then I have some breast pads. Obviously I know that my milk likely won't come in, but I will be in the hospital for a minimum of a week. So I'm hoping that my milk will come in by then. and I just wanted to have a few on hand. I know the hospital will likely give me some, but I just wanted to have a few in the diaper bag just in case. And then the very last thing I have is on the side compartment is a laminated copy of my birth plan. I've talked about this before, but I've decided to go ahead and be a little more lenient than I initially wanted to be, but that's just because I'm accepting the fact that I have to have a hospital birth. I'm accepting the fact that I will likely have to have intervention. And I want the best thing for Addison. So if that means I end up having to have an epidural or having to have a C-section, I'm prepared to do that. I want to bring her into this world as healthy and happy as possible. So I'm going to do whatever the best option is for us at that point. I'm going to try for as natural of a birth as possible, but the closer we're getting, I'll talk about this too in my update, closer we're getting, the less likely they're thinking that I will, I don't want to say, have a successful vaginal delivery, but more or less they're kind of leaning towards cesarean, which I'll talk about that in the next video. All right, so let's see the empty inside. It's really sizey, really roomy. So here's the little clear pouch, and then here's a pocket, and then that pocket comes up, and then there's the mesh compartments here and a zipper pocket along the side here. So if there's anything you think I should also be packing for Addison for the hospital, please let me know in the comments down below. Rate, comment, subscribe. Bye, guys.